Good morning, good morning, good morning to everyone. I hope you guys had better sleep than I did last night. It is exactly 10:17 a.m. and I am just now waking up. I didn't get to sleep until sometime way after 4 o'clock in the morning. So, yes, I hope you guys had better sleep than I did. Let me go ahead and address this week's topic for you all. Let's see, it's as a lesbian, gay, bisexual, or transgendered person, what are some examples of discrimination, judgment, and intolerance that you have experienced from people who you know? And how did you manage to overcome that and change the hearts and minds of those people so that they now accept and embrace who you are? I have been in the closet for a number of years, so I really don't have very many examples to share. There is one that really stands out in my memory database, and that is an incident that occurred, how many years ago was it? Maybe 3 years ago. My sister was dating this new guy, and they had a long-distance relationship, and I could tell that she really liked him. They had been dating for several months, and he would either drive out to see her or she would drive out to see him. And at this particular time, they needed a babysitter. So I was going to babysit for my sister and for him while they went out of town or something. And so this was going to be the first time that I actually got to meet him in person. And, you know, I met him. He was like this big, burly military dude. And we're going to call him Tyrone. Okay. So we're sitting down on the couch in my living room and we're all having just normal conversation. And then he goes on to talk about how, you know, he's going to be suspended from work. And I just, you know, was like, really? Why? And then he said, because I had to clean up my office with one of them gays. And I thought about it and I said, what do you mean? And then he went to telling me all about the story about the reason that he was suspended. He said, this was around the time when, for like that 6 month period when it was actually legal for homosexuals to get married in California. Remember that time? Well, during that time, this man, the gay officer in the military, we'll call him Bob. Bob got married to his partner and he came into the office where Tyrone was and he showed Tyrone his marriage certificate and he told Tyrone that he needed the government to sign it and to honor their marriage just like any other heterosexual marriage. And that so that he can get benefits for his partner. And Tyrone went on to say, and I quote, I'm not signing that shit. I'm not honoring that shit. And just going off and just causing all kind of commotion in the office. And from what he says, everybody was just kind of watching and letting everything just unfold. So, of course, it got to a point to where it escalated so much. And Bob just felt so offended that he tried to hit. He went off to try to hit Tyrone. What did he do that for? Because Tyrone, turns out, he is a self-defense teacher within the military on the base. And he turned Tyrone's attack back onto, not Tyrone, Bob's attack back onto Bob and wound up just taking Bob and just slamming his head into the desk, slamming his head into the computer, into the fax machine, and into everything. And just, you know, just knocking him all around like a rag doll. And while he's telling the story, I'm telling you, I could just roll up thinking about it while he's telling the story. I mean, his chest is just stuck out like he's so proud and he's so boastful about what he did to this gay person. Okay. And then he said that towards the end of the incident, this is so horrible, that the dude, Bob, was knocked unconscious. So, and then they rushed him off to the doctor, to the clinic within the base. And it was later announced that he had a concussion. So yeah, this is crazy, right? What kind of first impression is this? And he is like full of pride, and I was horrified. And my mother was sitting on the couch at the time. She didn't have any idea about me, and she was like cheering him on and smiling like, "Yeah, good for you." And Tyrone was like, "Yeah, we can't let them faggots get away with this shit." I mean, this is the kind of stuff that I was raised inside of, okay? And, you know, my sister, she was the only one who knew about me at the time. And she was just kind of quiet in the corner of the couch and just kind of looking down. And it was horrible. It was really horrible. I really didn't know what to say, but I knew that just from the visceral reaction that occurred within him, that I didn't want him to be continual dating my sister. And, you know, and I talked about her about that seriously afterwards, because I could see that he had some anger management problems. And I told him that. I said, "Do you have anger management problems?" And he said, "No, not at all." I said, "Well, it seems to me as if you do, because if you are a self-defense trainer, then you should have been able to stop Bob from attacking you without knocking him unconscious. You did that out of anger." And he's like, yes, it was out of anger, but he's gay, and you know, he shouldn't have touched me, and so he felt justified in that. And then he also said that he's going to get away with it. He said that he is not going to be suspended for long. He's not going to be fired in the end, he said, because everybody in there in the office and all around was watching it, and nobody intervened, and that everybody was cheering him on. And everybody liked what they were seeing, because we can't let them faggots get away with this. And I hate that word. So I told him, I said, "No, you're going to get fired for doing that. There's no way in the world that they are going to allow this to go on, this kind of blatant hate crime to go on in the offices." I said, "Somebody is going to report you. Somebody is going to tell the truth about what happened." And that's exactly what happened in the end. They did wind up firing him, and he had a very hard time finding a job after that. And, you know, to his surprise. What? I mean, really, it's the most horrible story ever. It's just so sad to see what childhood indoctrination will do to someone's mind. And that's what it really boils down to. And if you're someone who is struggling with your sexuality because it's not aligning with whatever belief system that you were raised inside of, you must know, hear me when I tell you, that there is nothing wrong with your natural attraction. There is nothing wrong with who you are. There is something wrong with the interpretation of the words that are being read. And there is something wrong with the current belief surrounding certain verses that is completely misconstrued. And so just know that there is nothing wrong with you. The only way that we can combat this kind of ignorance, this, you know, this kind of brainwashing, is to just remain a positive reflection of what it is to be LGBTQ. Just like Michelle, Sid, and Jim said, I mean, you know, once we open these people's minds and show them something different from what they have been taught, then, you know, their hearts are going to follow. Their hearts are definitely going to follow. And, you know, with more and more people awakening to the truth about life, really, and, you know, where the layers of conditioning are starting to unravel for a lot of people, I'm noticing, you know, we're getting there slowly but surely. Surely but slowly. So that's the only positive that's gonna, you know, that's coming out of this mess that we're in at this point. So anyway, thanks for listening to me. I hope you guys have a wonderful Saturday. Peace, love, harmony. Is there anyone ever remembers changing their mind from the paid on a sign? Is there anyone bringing calls for breaking the record out? Something someone yeah, be loud on time. Oh, everyone believes how they think it ought to be. Oh, everyone believes that I'm going easily.